starts in the fall.
Legal experts are predicting a relatively smooth confirmation for Sotomayor by the Senate. She was nominated to the bench by a Republican president and has won Senate approval twice before. KOSI's Ed Lenderman reports.
She's stated that she believes that the appellate courts where policy is developed, not in our halls of legislation, so it shows a little activism.
Republicans are predictably grumbling, but experts say Sonia Sotomayor's background and record on the bench doesn't give them much to chew on.
This is a judge who was appointed by George Bush Sr. She's a Yale Law School graduate, has a lot of experience both as a trial court judge and as an appeals court judge. So this is someone who it would seem would be involved in a relatively straightforward confirmation process.
Roe v. Wade will certainly come up during the confirmation process, but one of Sotomayor's most notable and controversial decisions doesn't involve abortion rights, but affirmative action. In a case pitting the city of New Haven, Connecticut versus its white firefighters, she sided with the city. Ironically, the case is now before the Supreme Court. That's not activism, says Professor Steinberg, but the interpretation of a statute. Republicans will also be hard-pressed to go after a Hispanic woman.
If you are someone that wants to be reelected to your Senate seat, why exactly do you want to go after the first Hispanic nominee and run the risk of alienating Hispanic voters in your constituency, particularly when, again, at first glance, this is not someone that seems to have a lot of issues?
Local Republican Congressman Brian Bilbray concedes her appointment to the court, but adds,
hopefully she doesn't need to represent anybody but the law and will interpret the law as written and not try to be an activist.